Welcome back to ANC ALERT. One Filipino-American leaves the corporate world to build a new life as a makeup artist. Bev Llorente has that story.
What color your client?
Leaving the corporate world to join the makeup industry was a life-changing experience for Kate Patrick. After joining and winning the International Hair and Makeup Olympics in 2010, she opened a makeup school in the Philippines for airbrushing.
Dito sa America, na-experience ko na din kasi na magtrabaho working with celebrities. So, pag hindi ka nila kilala, tapos isipin na Filipino ka, hindi ka nire-respeto right away. Pero pag makita nila yung credential mo, and then yung gawa mo, makita na nila yung gawa mo, then maniniwala sila, magaling pala to.
These are the before and after portfolio pictures of makeup Kay has done. From Hollywood to Dubai and into the Southeast Asian countries, she has done it all. Kay says that breaking into the makeup industry is quite a challenge since a lot of Filipinos are makeup and beauty enthusiasts. But rising above the challenge makes it more fulfilling.
Masyadong competitive. Kasi marami ring magagaling dito. Yes, maraming Filipinos, but I think being on top of your field, like making it possible for you to reach for the next level, like in my case, nag-aral ako lalo. I want to specialize in not just paramedical makeup, but also in high-definition airbrush makeup, which is intended for HD camera and 4K technology.
In 2009, Kay also won the Hair Asia's Battle of the Champions in Makeup. By doing so, she was able to acquire an EB-1 visa or employment-based extraordinary ability green card that allows her to stay in America as a permanent resident.
To qualify for that type of visa, it's either you are a Nobel Prize winner or you're an Olympic awardee or PhD. So, but it also covers arts and science or mathematics. But in my case, since I joined the Olympics, so nag-qualify ako for that.
For now, Kay Patrick will stay in the makeup world, but has future plans to start a makeup school in Las Vegas. Bev Llorente, ABS-CBN News, Las Vegas.